Welcome to DDub TV, everyone. I hope you're having a great day so far. Today's video is a real treat because I'll be talking about Episode 3 in Ghost Recon Breakpoint and showing you lots of footage from these new Red Patriot missions. After that, I'll be showing you some of the awesome new Bodart gear and the Sentinel 553 Scout, which is the DMR blueprint you get for completing the final Red Patriot mission. Also, if you're new to the channel and enjoy videos about open world and shooter games like Breakpoint, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. I'm gonna start off by saying that these Episode 3 missions are really, really good. They are locked behind the Year 1 pass, but if you don't have that pass, you can still finish two of the missions for free. I bought the Year 1 pass back when Ubisoft had their first big Ubisoft Forward sale, and I'm really glad I did because these Red Patriot missions and rewards alone make the Year 1 pass worth buying in my opinion. You can also buy Episode 3 for 1900 Ghost Coins, which might be the way to go for people who have been playing Breakpoint for a while, considering that Ubisoft has given away around 1000 Ghost Coins just for past glitches and issues affecting the game. Anyway, Breakpoint made some really good changes when it comes to Episode 3, and I definitely feel like the developers are taking this game in the right direction. The most notable change with Episode 3 is the layout of the missions. It's a lot like Wildlands in a way, because you have multiple targets that act as underbosses, then you have the main boss, which is Trey Stone, the leader of Sentinel. You can take out the underbosses in any order you like, and each one has a really cool set of rewards like the AK-74 Survival and Bodart gear. One of the things I really liked about Episode 3 is that there weren't any cutscenes. You traveled to a certain bivouac, received a radio call from Scott Mitchell, then went after the objective. Every set of missions for each boss was unique and exciting, but they could have been a little bit longer. Some of these missions or assassinations were actually pretty difficult to pull off, like the one where you gotta kill Sphinx in the middle of a wolf camp, and the one where you kill Harpy after assaulting the testing zone in Driftwood Isles. I really enjoyed the variety in Episode 3 as you didn't just have to kill 10 targets. You had to follow leads, destroy property, and even make time-sensitive decisions in order to flush out the different bosses before you could get to them. What I love the most about this DLC though is definitely the new Bodart gear. It's just so cool looking, especially the masks, and I think this gear really fits well into the whole Ghost Recon theme. There are also enough masks for your AI teammates, so you can go for that complete Bodark squad look like I did. Breakpoint definitely needed gear like this. The Sam Fisher gear from Episode 2 was cool and everything, but personally, I feel like Ubisoft is kind of overusing Sam Fisher lately. I mean, he was already in Wildlands, and now he's gonna be in Rainbow Six Siege, but when I'm playing Ghost Recon, I just wanna be Ghost Recon, not Splinter Cell or Terminator or anything else. That's just my personal preference, but the bottom line is I'm happy we got new gear from Ghost Recon rather than from another game for a change. And then there's the Sentinel 553 Scout, which is a really cool looking DMR, but honestly it's not my favorite. I really like it for its unique appearance, but with all the other great DMRs out there, there's not a whole lot that makes the 553 stand out from the crowd. It does have pretty good range and reload speed, but if I'm using a DMR, I'll use something like the MK17 Scout or the new M4A1 Scout you get for reaching level 10 as the Pathfinder. But I have been experimenting with different attachments for the 553 and I do still really like it. One thing I noticed while trying out different attachments on the 553 is that it uses assault rifle magazines rather than DMR mags, even though it is very clearly labeled as a DMR. But that's gonna wrap up this video. I hope you enjoyed listening to me ramble on about Episode 3. I had a lot of fun playing through these new missions, and I'll definitely be working on a separate video where I rank these Red Patriot missions from best to worst, so if you'd like to see that, then stay tuned. But as always, thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it, and if you decide to come back for some more open world and shooter action, then I will see you in the next video.